Okay, welcome to How to Bricolage on Instagram with Dr. Bricolage. For those of you who don't know, bricolage is just creating something with what's available. So let's get into it. All right, fire up Instagram. Some wild eyebrows. Those are my legs. What's up? What's up? All right, so you got to start with a photo, right? Photos are available to us on Instagram. I keep a collection. I guess I call it street peep scenes, and I just add to it as I walk around. So for this one, I wanted something just simple, a photo, not a video. Sometimes I use videos, but I want something sort of plain. So I landed on this guy with the black car, sort of neutral colors. And so that's what I start researching. At first, I jump into the archives, right? So we're gonna use our GIF archives because that's what's really available. So I start with black flower, right? I wanted to, some neutral tones. I wanted to start with simple color. Found this cool scribble, thought it matched some of the tar work on the empty parking lot, so I put that out there. Again, I sort of went into this with a plan too, and that'll be apparent later as I tested some things before to sort of save you the trouble. Oh, I like this eagle, but it didn't work, so I'm gonna chuck that guy in the trash. All right, so going back to that scribble, I sort of like the way it connects there. I often, anyone sort of knows the power of threes, so especially with GIFs and objects, I often work in threes. So I grab another scribble, I line that up, sort of play around with some positioning. Where do I want to put it? Do I want to connect sort of the tar spots? Do I want to highlight the car? Do I want to play off that major sort of dividing line in the middle? And that's what I land on. All right, so now I decide we need some characters in here, and we're going to have a sort of progression. So the idea is we're going to make three or four quick 5 second animations that'll play off each other. So I download this to save it as it's really simple template to build off of. And then I'm going to go in and I'm going to say, all right, we need some characters. So again, I'm sticking with the neutral theme. So I'm searching by color. And so that's sort of my tactic. Black, weird. I do that a lot. I'll say black and I'll make up a word, or green and I'll make up a word. And I like this little cat dancing right up top. Yeah, look at that. Dang, dang, getting busy. Looks good. Look at that. Look at that thing on top of that car. Let's go. And I want two of them. Looks a little lonely. So I fire up another one. And then I sort of think, I'm going to play with scale and movement. So I'm going to start them way back there. It looks like they're doing a little end zone touchdown dance, doing the Dion or something. So I'm gonna start with them back there and decide that, over the course of the animation, we'll move them forward. So eventually, we'll need to save three animations. That's not quite complete just as is with just them dancing. So again, keeping neutral tones. I search gray. I got this cool little drip thing. It looks like a oil slick or something. Adds a little trippiness, a little action coming in from the left side. And I like this. So the bottom third is sort of clean and basic, and then all our actions in the top two thirds. So looking around for other things, gray circle, I don't like it. Just gray. What does the gray color give me? I find this little sphere thing, and it's like, all right, let's spruce up that Subaru, that Bebop, that little wagon, whatever that thing is. It's about to be a G wagon, so let's get it going. Those aren't spinners, but those things will make that thing cruise. All right, so once it's like that, that's feeling pretty good as a basic start, right? All right, and I love taking cityscapes and adding sort of flora and fauna and having nature take over. So I play around looking for some trees, some gray trees, some neutral trees, some tree lines, something that'll fit in, right? The archives are deep, so you can really search a lot of things. So I sort of like that one, sort of flitting between the green and the black, but decided to chuck it. And yeah, looking at this, it's basic, but I know that I'm going to build up to something, so I save that, right? So that'll be my first animation. All right, so now getting text, ignore that. So now I'm going to bring these guys closer. So over the course of the three animations, right, these cats are going to move closer. So now they're on top of this thing, getting busy. So that's how that'll be. And I save that one. So in the second round, they'll be there. And now, on the third round, is when I'm sort of planning a big shift. So I'm going to switch from these very plain neutral tones to a lot of color. So I start messing around with rainbows and things. Ignore those texts. That's Little McLean. All right, so I get the rainbow coming in, so that gray neutral drip's going to be replaced by this bright colorful drip. The idea being when I put music to it, there'll be some sort of drop, right? Drop will hit, and everything will turn to color. So that's what I'm building towards now. So I get those gray wheels off the car, and now I want some, yeah, I want that rainbow drip, 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 drip. And there's mad rainbow stuff in the GIF archive, so you can really dig into them. And I'm searching rainbow weird. You can really just make up some words because people are making GIFs all over the world in different languages, so sometimes you don't know how they'll be labeled. I took notes on sort of a plan earlier, so I chucked that in there. All right, so here we go. Rainbow line, I think, was what I'm after. So I come in here, I get that. That's going to replace those simple wheels. I got to type in a couple times. Sometimes I'll use one object, you know, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 times. This one's a little more simple, so to keep it short and sweet. But when I'm typing something a bunch, I'll just like copy the word and then paste it to avoid typing it. Vapor, this is one of my go-tos. I love this little thing. I use it in a fair amount of my animations, but like that's how you know that car's on that vroom vroom. All right, so that's getting piled in there. Gonna add a little sparkle to it too. I don't know if you can see that though, that got that glittery dust. It'll be coming out of the exhaust. So when that beat drops, we'll know that car's ready to go. All right, so now it's starting to look, man, it was a sad, gray, desolate parking lot, but now it's looking like a party. So we're gonna get these guys doing the thing up close and centered, right? So we're playing with scale. Obviously, they started small in the back and they get bigger. So a lot of times for these animations to create depth, you just play with scale. So I'm playing with the size of these GIFs. All right, I really like, if you've seen my other animations or even drawings, like I like having these like holes or portals that sort of allow random things to happen, right? It's like if I'm creating rules in this world, if I put a hole, anything can come out of a hole. It's a little like Rick and Morty-ish or cartoonish, right? It's like a hole means we don't know what's on the other side of that. And so in this case, I'm getting a dump of color. So I'm searching for other rainbow things. I got this thing, little rainbow road action for you Mario Kart heads out there. All right, and then I flip it so I got the red on the left because the purple side had a weird angle on it. And then I'm gonna spend a little time just nicing it out right up against so it looks like it's actually behind that pole that's going across there. So that's another thing, right? If you're adding GIFs and animations to a photo, playing with how things interplay, so overlapping is how we create depth. And if I convince the eye that that rainbow road is behind that horizontal pole, then it's really going to feel like it's in the background, so that hole is in the parking lot, the rainbow's coming out of it, and it's disappearing behind that pole because the pole's in front of it. So our eyes read that in that way. So once I get that, yep, and I touched it and it got screwed up, so I'm getting the hole in place. That's the other thing, playing with GIFs and Instagram is incredibly frustrating. If you've done it, you know that, right? You're trying to pick up one GIF, you pick up something else, and so sometimes you got to start all over. All right, so I get the hole in place, I get the rainbow in place, and then I got to get the rainbow in front of the hole, so I tap it, boom, now it looks like it's coming out of the hole. The hole's in the sidewalk. Where'd that come from? What? All right, that's looking pretty good. I want some more stuff though, right? All right, rainbow plant. I told you I like plants, so now I'm searching here. What do we got? There's some cool things there. I got these little things. Put them on top of the whip. Damn. All right, now, as I said, right, I'm going to copy rainbow plants because I decide I'm going to use a few of these. I don't want to type rainbow plants every time, so now I can copy-paste it. Rainbow plants, go and get it. Copy-paste, go and get it. And just along the bottom half of the screen, we're going to create with those almost holographic rainbow plants will go going across. So we scale them up, bazank, get it in place, get the next one. We want them to overlap so there's a little bit of continuity. And we're keeping them in that Roy G. Biv, right? Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet. Those are your colors in the rainbow spectrum of light that we can see. Turns out I only needed three of them to get across the whole screen, so I dumped that fourth one. Alright. Now, the stars of the show, let's get them in place, sort of center them out. Feels a little sparse, right? So we're going to play around with some things here. You know, I like crowning random things. I like crowning my biomorphs, you know, whether it's a cat dancing or a pigeon or whatever. So I play around with the crown. I didn't like it above their head because their hands went behind it, and if they were wearing a crown, their hands would go in front of it. And you know, I know that's picky, but some visual rules I don't like to break, and that was one of them. So I was looking for some clouds or maybe something that they could be dancing on top of, right? They felt where their feet meets the pole feels a little fake to me still. Like, you know, obviously it's a cartoon sitting on a real life pole. However, I wanted to add something there. So I try the crowns down there. And to be honest, I don't love that look. It looks a little too go-go-ish, like they're trapped up there or something. So we try the crown again. What can I say? We're all kings and queens. I just like crowning stuff. I like it, but yeah, as I say, you see how the hands go behind it? Screw that. So we chuck that crown. And we decide, we play around with this crown. Maybe we could think about putting it across the pole. But I don't like that. Get that garbage out of there. Take that to St. Elsewhere. Cousin Gray's like, what's up, what's up, what's up? All right. So now I decide we're there on the pole. I want to create a little shadow, but there isn't a shadow GIF, right? So sometimes you got to create something out of nothing. So it's sort of ridiculous how many times I've searched for shadow, but they haven't made one. So I have a few tricks that I use. One of them is trying to spell shadow correctly. Anyways, can't find a shadow. I don't want to put them just, I don't want the dancers coming out of a hole because they've been there the whole time. They're part of this, you know, parking lot reality. So I think about maybe putting them on a cloud to sort of blend their feet into the pole. Don't think I'm satisfied with any of these clouds. So I leave it for a minute, play around with some gold dust. You know how it is. We keep it bougie, right? Because we want this thing to pop off. So now, I mean, that's pretty subtle, but it looks like, see that little gold dust in there, a little confetti popping off. And then we're going to double down on that. Cop that glitter in the upper right there, and then make it much bigger, right? So now, yeah, it looks like these cats won the Super Bowl or some shit. All right. Now this is starting to look like a little party, right? So when that music drops, it's going to be fun. So I'm already, as I'm building this, I'm starting to think about what songs I'm going to use. All right, but their feet, right? I still want their feet. I want their feet lined up. So now I'm just like, all right, gray dots or something I can make a shadow out of, right? So I just say dots, and I find those little black things, right? And I see, all right, I need a lot more than one of these. So I copy paste it, and then this is the minutia of this, right? And as I said, this is a fairly quick one, and this is sped up at like 1.5 times the speed, so everything's moving a little fast. So you'll see at the final version will be a little slower. But anyways, sometimes when you're bricolaging, you got to go get a lot of the same thing over and over again. So dots, 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 dots. So I go and get my dots. Because we're making shadows, you know? We want this, we got a standard to upkeep here. Alright, so I get my dots. I'm a little worried, right? Because I have that scribble. Yep, see, I grabbed the scribble by accident. So that's, again, a thing with GIFs. You know, when you pile them up, they don't know which one you're trying to move. So I was trying to move the dots, but I moved the scribble. So I just get the scribble out of the way for a minute. I get my dots, right? But the dots register on top of the cats. So I got to click the cats twice to make sure they're on top of the dots. Get the scribble back in place. Then I noticed when I was searching dots, we got that cool gold vortex thing, right? Boom. So now I put that in there. Now our dots are flying all over the place. So now we're getting into the post-pandy type of party scene that, you know, we're all missing, right? So then I save that, right? So I save that, and now I say, all right, now I'm going to go back and build it. So, right, I'm building this in story, so I didn't want to post that one first because that's the end one. I was listening to Small Town Murder. I gotta turn that John off. All right, so then I go back, I double check, I make sure I have them all saved, right? That's saved. I don't want to leave the story because the stories don't save your work. So that's the other thing. If you screw up and you don't save it, that's gone. So now I close the story, right? lose all that work, but I saved it so I can go back and start from the beginning, right? So I go in, I pull up the first one, right? The sort of plain neutral parking lot. So now you're getting an idea of how this will go. And now we start searching music. Music's a huge part of this. For this one right now, I was consulting. I keep a running list of songs that I like, and I was sort of looking at them. I didn't have an exact song in mind. Again, I wanted a drop, a nice drop that's going to be something that people would dance to, and then maybe, you know, the cats have a specific rhythm to them. So again, if it's a song that I can actually match that rhythm, even the better. I've been vibing off this Roots song for a long time, so I went and played around with that. It didn't quite fit. And yeah, so sometimes I'll spend, you know, 2 hours making one of these and then 2 hours figuring out the music, to be honest. So I was trying to see if the drop would work with it, but what the issue with this is the cats are already dancing. So I needed a song that wasn't, you know, it's danceable to begin with, right? It had a distinct beat the cats could be moving to. And then when the drop hits, it's sort of just kicked up a notch. So this doesn't work. So I get out of here and actually go into Spotify and start messing around to find the right thing. I play around with a lot of stuff. I'm not going to share it here because it's just going to take up too much time. And so I land on Save by Tez. Super fun track, a bunch of drops, and it just fit the mood of this, you know, sort of gray, neutral tune parking lot turning into this little, you know, gold sparkled rainbow dance party. So I went with it. I actually can't find the exact edit I want. You know, I want the radio cut, but I can't find it. But I realized that deep within this song has the actual 15 seconds we're after, right? So each one of these photos, when you do a photo on Instagram with the music to it, can only be 5 seconds. If it's a video or certain songs, it can be longer, 15 seconds or more. But as of now, so there's three of these animations at 5 seconds each, and then maybe a fourth, like I just do an extra one of the last scene when they're partying, so maybe 15, 20 seconds. So right now I'm just playing around with trying to figure out the right 15, 20 seconds of this song to get. And it's got to be exact, right? You want those transitions to be nice. Unfortunately, you know, this is sort of a lo-fi DIY way of creating, and I'm not downloading the song and putting it into it in an editing program. I'm just putting it into it on Instagram. And so you just want to line them up so each one of those 5 second things blend into it, right? So we get the song in there. And then once it's there, I'm going to post it, right? I make sure it's good. Post it to the story. Ayo, what's up? Caught off, shout out online. Looks like that. All right, so I double check it. It's up there. Back there are my legs again. I got a cat toy strewn across me because I was multitasking, playing with my cat. All right, so now I get to bring up the second one. Again, go back in. Going to go find the same song. The Tez Cat Katie Caddy song. Right, get to the exact spot. So that first one will blend into this one, lined up on that bottom bar. Bada bing, bada boom. All right, let's go. Fire that up, right? Get rid of the sticker. Send it. Boom. All right, now we're gonna do a third one, right? So now we're gonna bring up the party scene. Yes, my cat toy is just a yellow climbing rope. All right, so there's the party scene. Go get that music, right? And now if we did our math right, you know, this one's gonna start on the drop. So I think the drop was at 238. Boom, 238, there it is. Let's go. Got them boys going. So we fire that up. Gonna send it. And boom, done. Cut off online is live. Look at that. That's nice timing. All right. And so then now I know the whole thing's up there. Double check that. And then to get it into one clip, what I do is then go into Instagram, my archives. Right. Make sure it's all there. So I'm gonna go into Instagram archives. And screen record. So this is a screen recording of a screen recording at this point. So this is our meta phase. So I'm screen recording the archive, right? Because this will have it the full 20 seconds. So I did decide to do an extra 10 second. Again, this is 1.5 speed, so it's a little faster, right? So we got two of these at the end with the dudes grooving. And then in a second here, we'll have the regular speed finish product. But so I save that into my photos. There we go, I was making some memes. And then I have to edit it, right? So of that screen recording, I only want those 20 seconds. So I pop in here and finagle it just to get those exact 20 seconds, not the whole other screen recording that I'm doing for this voiceover, if that makes sense. We're getting super heady right now. All right, so I just want those 20 seconds of the actual video. And then what that does is that gives me, you know, that gives me what you see on Dr. Bricolage on the page or in the booth is like those, you know, 20 second clips, and I can do whatever I want with that. This one, I'm keeping the, saving it as a new video, and I'm keeping the top because it has those guys in it. So in a second here, we will get the real deal. All right, and then what I'm doing here, right, I'm just cropping it, but I want to keep them in there. Save that, John. We'll see the real thing. Make sure it's legit. Party, party, party. All right, and then, yeah, we'll be able to see it in live time, right? So the real 20 seconds. Here it is. 3, 2, 1. Yep, there it is. I hope everyone enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Thanks to Cutoff. Go out there and make something. If you got Instagram, give me a follow. Give me a shout. Let me know if you have questions. Thank you and peace.